big bulletproof will never die.
What do you want to say, Ed?
Hi. Hi. Final assembly. Those are usually the guys I give the most heat.
Ed, this guitar is part of, I think, an amazing journey of yours. You know, it really represents this evolution of your knowledge and your taste and your tone chasing. You know, the guitar had been around for about 20 years, electric guitar, and you weren't satisfied with that. What really set you off and to find your own sound and your own voice?
I'm constantly putzing with stuff. Tone chasing. Closing my eyes and just playing a guitar and the feel of it and this and that. And the previous Wolfgang, you know, we put it this way, the new Wolfgang is a culmination of about 35 years or more. Everything that I've destroyed, everything that I've stumbled onto, you know, is in this guitar. You know, it's everything I know, everything that I know and I've experienced in my journey to where we are now. I've never used or owned any distortion pedal. Nothing, you know. I always use the guitar cable straight to the amp. A lot of people, until they actually play my guitar through one of my amps, then they go, holy shit. I remember Billy Corgan from Smashing Pumpkins, he interviewed me once. And it was up in the studio, and my rig happened to be set up, and I was playing, he walked in, and he kind of nervously said, can I try it? Oh, sure. He turned it up, and it was just uncontrollable for him, you know? And he goes, where's your distortion pedal? I'm like, it isn't one.
Right, right.
If you have a great sounding guitar, you know, a quality instrument, and of course a good amp, and you know how to talk, or make the guitar talk, that's the key. To me, anything you put in between that deviates, takes away from the pure tone. But it starts with the guitar and knowing what you want it to sound like and feel like. What we did with the new Wolfgang was the only similarity, and even that's changed a bit, the only thing that's the same is the body shape. That's it. Every little damn thing. You know, the way the neck bolts on, the frets, the tuning pegs, the binding, the pickups, the tailpiece, the pots, even cavities in it to help the wood breathe so it ages better. You know, there is, you know, even the jack, you know, every little thing. The basics of the guitar to the painstaking aesthetics of the binding and everything else, we left no stone unturned. You know, we redid everything on this guitar. Like I said earlier, the only similarity to the other Wolfgang, the previous model, is the body style.
I think one of the most brilliant things you did, though, was to take this guitar out on the road on the biggest tour of, you know, the last 2 years and road test it. I mean, that's a really bold move to do.
It had to be done. I don't let anything out unless I've dragged it around the block, meaning taking it on tour and just beat the living shit out of it. And, you know, everything from the guitar has stainless steel frets.
Right.
Okay, I don't know what other people think of them, but, you know, they just kick ass. You know, no flat spots, they don't wear out.
Right.
If anyone thinks that it takes away from tone, they're crazy. You know, it has nothing to do with tone.
Right.
You know, if it's a bogus guitar, it doesn't matter what kind of frets you put in it. Stainless steel frets was like a major breakthrough because for the amount of playing I do in bending, you know, it's like I'd have to get it refretted every couple of months.
Right.
You know, whole tour.
These frets here,
You played half the tour on this guitar. Mm-hmm. It looks like a brand new fret job.
And I played it way before we went on tour.
Mm-hmm.
You don't want to hop out on the track, you know, with a, I don't know, a wheel bearing that's going to go bad or something.
That's right.
No, I'm serious.
You know, well, you're talking about doing 190 miles an hour, you know.
Well, that's it. So. I'm doing 275 on stage, and I don't want this wheel bearing going out. Starting from scratch alleviated a lot of problems, which gave me the confidence to take it on tour. You know, there were actually very minor tweaks that we did on the road because of all the preparation that we did. The Wolfgang better outlive me.
Right.
Period. My name or my son's name's on it.
But, right. Yeah. Well, your name too.
But it better last forever, like a Stradivarius. It's not a fad. It is, you know, 35, 40 years of my knowledge of what makes a sweet, sexy, tony, quality, indestructible instrument that I'm very proud of. And I'm proud to have this team that stuck with me throughout all.
It's an honor.
Yeah.
It really is. One thing that surprised me about this project is how versatile this guitar is. When I first got involved with it, I thought that we were just going to make something that's loud and nasty, and you can make it squeal like a pig when you want to. But, you know, just running on the clean channel, we did half of our testing on the clean channel, you know, just
it's sweet.
It cleans up so nicely. You can do anything.
Well, I want the guitar. I don't want to have to fight the damn thing.
Right.
You know? I want to be able to speak to it, and it delivers the message.
Yeah.
You know? It works with me. And the easier, the better. I don't like wrestling the damn thing.
Yeah, and it's all personal preference. So, I mean, after all said and done of what we've gone through and what we're saying here and today, the true test is go play one.
Yeah.
You know, you can listen to us all day long, but the best product is the one that sells itself. And, you know, I think that I know what we put into it, and it is. I mean, you can listen to us, but, you know, go play one.
This guitar is a culmination of, you know, years and years of trial and error.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of errors, but a lot of breakthroughs.
Yeah. And a lot of trial, too, but that's, it's... Again, it's unprecedented, I think, in this industry of just this time and this effort and attention to detail. The most minute detail, I think, just really is remarkable. You know.
And so many guys spend so much time tweaking their guitars. You know, the last 2 years, we figured it all out for you.
Yeah.
You know, there's nothing left to do on it. And shame on you if you want to swap anything out on this, because you're not going to find anything better.